Hello everyone, welcome to Physics 4 AP. So today we are going to discuss about the another theory which belongs to the chemical bonding, which is called the valency bond theory. So after the failures of electronic theory of valency and valency shell electron pair repulsion theory, so the valency bond theory that we call as VBT has been successfully explained the bond angle, the bond strength, the complete exact structure of a compound. So this was done by a quantum mechanical model. So this is also called as a quantum mechanical model, which was explained by Linus Pauling. So Linus Pauling, as we have discussed in the structure of atom about the Pauli's exclusion principle. So same here, the person, again, the Linus Pauling in the year 1954 had explained a valency bond theory. So what he has explained is two atoms combined together by overlapping its valency orbital containing unpaired electron attracts the nuclei of both the atoms and bond together. Like for example, what we take as H2 molecule. So as H2 molecule, we have electronic configuration as 1s1. That means the structure of the s orbital is the spherical. So this is for one hydrogen atom as a spherical, and this is another hydrogen atom which is the spherical. So when they combine together, they get attracted towards the nuclei. That is, the electron which is present in this nuclei, the electron which is present in this atom is being attracted to the nucleus of this hydrogen atom, and the electron which is present in this hydrogen atom is being attracted to the nucleus of this hydrogen atom. Hence, they both combine together and form a paired electron and form a bond between the two hydrogen atoms and form as a H2 molecule. So that is what he is saying by the overlapping of the atomic orbitals. So the orbitals which are having the valency electrons or the unpaired electrons, they get bound together, they get overlap and form a complete structure. So we get the molecule as H2 molecule also here. And next, the greater the overlapping orbital, stronger will be the bond. So the greater the overlap, when they intermix together, when they mix together, more mixing together, more overlapping or greater overlapping, the stronger will be the bond. Less overlapping, the bond will be the weak. And each bond maintains its own atomic orbital. So each bonded atom, has its atomic orbitals, but the electron pair in the overlapping orbitals is shared by both the atoms involved in the overlapping. So as here we have the electron pair. So this electron pair, which we have here, two electrons. So this electron pair is shared by the two atoms which is present here. So here we have a paired electron which is bonded here, and this bonded paired electron is shared between this hydrogen atom and this hydrogen atom. That means this bonded pair atom electron is being bonded with the two atoms present over here, with the two nucleus. So that is what they are saying here. And we have in the fourth point, that is the sigma bonds. So which are the stronger bonds by overlapping of orbitals along the internuclear axis. Like just now I told you, the greater the overlapping, the stronger will be there. The stronger bond, which we name them as the sigma bond, the weak bond, which we call them as the pi bond. So the pi bond or weaker bond by end or head overlap or lateral overlap of the p orbital. So we say the sigma bond as the overlapping of the atomic orbitals by internuclear axis. For example, here we have a p orbital, and also here we have a p orbital. So when these two combine together, so the internuclear axis, so these nuclear axes get combined together. So these two nuclear axes combined together with the head-on-head overlapping, there we get a bond which we call it as sigma bond, and these sigma bonds are the strong bonds. And lateral overlap. So lateral overlap means there will be overlapping sidewise. So headwise, which we make them combine together, so which we call them as a sigma bond, and the same orbitals which are been lateral overlap, like in a sideways, like they're partially bonded here. So the partially bonded here, which are called as lateral overlap, here we get the pi bond. So we will be seeing a small video about the sigma bond and pi bond, how the electrons revolve on these orbitals over here. So let's see an animated video of sigma bond and pi bond. So this is about the hydrogen atom and s orbital and p orbital. So when they combine, we get a sigma bond. So when they overlap head on head, also here we get a sigma bond over here. So two spherical bond, that is s orbitals, combine to form a huge s orbital. As if we see the nucleus which is present in the two atomic orbitals get attracted to each other. And now we are when we are discussing about the pi bond, so then we laterally overlap, like sideways, as we can see in the video, so which we call lateral overlapping. So when they combine laterally, like in a sideways, so we get a pi bond, which is the weaker bond over here. So now we will be seeing the formation of N2 molecule and also the O2 molecule also with the help of the valency bond theory. So here we have the nitrogen N2. So nitrogen, we have 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. As we know, in p orbital we have three degenerating orbitals which are called as px, py and pz, and with little simplification of this electronic configuration we write it as 1s2, 2s2, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1. That means here we have three unpaired electrons, that is px, py, pz. So three unpaired electrons with the now these three unpaired electrons are drawn over here. So this is the px orbital and this is the py orbital and pz, this is the pz orbital. So x-axis, which is the px, y-axis, which is the py, and z-axis, which is the pz. The same as for the another nitrogen molecule also. Now when these two nitrogen molecules combine together like this, so when they come closer and when they combine together, as you can see, the internuclear axes, the internuclear axes get combined together. So here we have a head-on-head overlap. So this head-on-head overlap, we get a sigma bond. That is, here we have sigma px bond px. So we call it as sigma px bond px. That is, the px orbitals gets a strong bond as they have been overlapping head-on-head with the internuclear axis. So we get a strong bond, which is the sigma bond. And coming to the py orbital over here, py orbital has been combining with the py of another nitrogen nitrogen atom, so they have been partially combined. So as they have been partially combined, so here we have an orbital bond which we called as pi bond, that is pi py py. So we have a pi bond in a pi py py. And at the same time, when coming to the pz orbital, so the pz orbital also combined together, which is the laterally overlapping. So we here we get also a pi bond, that is pz bond pz. Now here we have nitrogen as a triple bond. So nitrogen has a triple bond consisting of one sigma bond and two pi bonds here, one and two. That is one sigma bond, that is px px one sigma bond, and one py py and one pz pz. So nitrogen molecule consists of a triple bond, which is one sigma bond and two pi bonds over here. So this is the formation of N2 molecules with the help of the orbitals, like the valency bond theory. Now at the same way, when we draw for the oxygen molecule, so let us draw for the oxygen molecule. So oxygen atomic number as 8. So when we write the electronic configuration as 1s2, 2s2 and 2p4. So when we simplify this, so here we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So here the px orbital is completely filled and py and pz are unpaired electrons. So we write the electronic configuration as 1s2, 2s2, 2px2, as 2 is being filled over here, 2py1 and 2pz1. Now as you can see, the py and pz orbitals are unpaired electrons with the px and the remaining are paired electrons, so they won't involve in the bond formation. So only the py orbital and pz orbitals get combined in the bond formation. So when we draw the structure of oxygen molecule, so we take this as one py orbital. So we take this as a py orbital and another as pz orbital. So this is a pz orbital. Now this is for one oxygen atom, and it has been combined with another oxygen atom. The same also here we have the py, and this is the pz. So this is the py and here we have pz. Now when these two oxygen atoms combine together to form O2 molecules, and you can clearly combine here, there only two p orbital, that is py and pz, are being combining here. So easily you can find out which is the forming the sigma bond and which is forming the pi bond here. That easily we can represent it. So this is the py orbital of one oxygen atom, and this is another py orbital of another oxygen atom. So here we have a sigma bond which is between the py and py. So we have one sigma py bond pyo here, and at the same time the pz orbital. So this is the pz orbital and pz orbital. So the pz orbitals are been combined laterally, like in a sideways. So these two are the pz are being combining laterally. So here we have a pi bond, that is the pi bond is between the pi pz bond pz. Now we know that the oxygen forms the double bond, it forms double bond. So that in that double bond, one is the sigma bond and another one is the pi bond over here. So this is about the formation of O2 molecule and N2 molecule with the valency bond theory. And also it's very easy, and all you need to understand is about the orbital shape over here. So when the orbitals combine head on head together, so sigma bond, and when they combine sidewise, which are partially overlapping, then we get a pi bond. So as pi sigma bond is nothing but the, we get the strong greater overlapping, and the py, that is pi bond combining over here, the pi bond, which are the weak bond, which are partially overlapping over here. So this is about the valency bond theory. So we have the another concept also based upon the valency bond theory, which we call it as the hybridization. This is the most important hybridization, which the plays an important role in the formation of the structure, the bond angle and everything. So this hybridization. So let us see the definition of hybridization. So hybridization is the phenomena of intermixing of atomic orbitals of almost equal energy, which are present in the outer shell of atom, and their reshuffling and redistribution into same number of orbitals, but their equal properties like energy and shape. So this is about the statement, that is the definition of the hybridization. So let's go deeper into the what is the hybridization, as the definition seems to be bigger, but it's very easier when we simplify it in a block wise. So you will be seeing that what is the meaning of hybridization. So before going into that, let's have a brief about the hybridization, like the excited state and the ground state. So you need to know about the excited state and the ground state over here. So let us see, when we take the BeCl2, beryllium chloride. So beryllium chloride, as we have done for the valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, let us take the beryllium. So when we take the beryllium, so beryllium atomic number is 4. So when we write the electronic configuration, we write it as 1s2 and 2s2. That is, and when we coming to the p orbital, so p orbital is empty, so we write it as p2p0, as there is no p orbital over there. So what happened here, this we call it as the ground state. So with this we call it as a ground state. And what we call the excited state is, that is when the chlorine atoms get combined together to the beryllium. That is when beryllium is been combining with the chlorine atoms. So what happened here is the electron which is in the present in the ground state will be jump into the excited state. So let's see how it's going to be here. So 1s2, one electron which is present in the s orbital will jump to the p orbital. 2s1 and 2p1. This is what we call it as the excited state. So this is what we call as excited state. So as if you see the ground state, as we don't have any electron in p orbital, but when coming to the excited state, due to the bond forming the between the chlorine atoms and the beryllium atoms, so the electron which is present in the s orbital will move on to the p orbital here. That means in 2s1 here, one electron means which we have in x, 2px1, 2py0 and 2pz0. So that means py and pz are not over there, as we have only one electron, it will move on to the px orbital only. So just we will be removing the py and pz, and here we have only s orbital and p orbital. So s orbital we have the shape which we call it as the spherical shape, and the px orbital which we call the dumbbell shape, which we call as the dumbbell shape. Now according to the definition of the hybridization, which we call the definition of hybridization, as if you see over here, the phenomena of intermixing of atomic orbitals of almost equal energies. Why? Because we are saying as equal energies which are present in the outermost shell. So this belongs to the outermost shell. So this belongs to the outermost shell over here, the 2s2p. So as they are the second orbit, so which we call them as the outermost shell, and they have almost equal energies. Why? Because with the variation of the orbitals only, but all belongs to the same shell which have almost equal energies. So the phenomenon of intermixing of atomic orbitals of almost equal energies. So these atomic orbitals, the spherical and the dumbbell shape, that is the s orbital and the p orbital, are going to intermix together. And so how they are going to intermix together? By reshuffling and redistribution of same number of orbitals, but with equal properties like energy and shape. Now, so when these two orbitals, the spherical and the dumbbell shape, when these two combine together, so we get a shape like, when these two gets combined, we get the shape of the beryllium. Now this is the shape of the beryllium atom, the central atom which we call as the beryllium. Is it clear now? Now this is the shape of the beryllium atom, which has equal energies on both sides and equal shape on also on the both sides over here. Now this beryllium atom is been going to combine with the p orbital and chlorine. Like we have electronic configuration as 17, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. So 3p5, so when we take the 3p5, so 1 2 3 4 5, that means px has been completed, py has been completed, and pz we have only one pair of electrons, that is one dumbbell shape, and that dumbbell shape will be get combined with this beryllium, and another chlorine will be get combined with this. So this is the chlorine atom. Now this is the complete structure for the beryllium atom, beryllium molecule. So the middle, which is the when it go into the hybridization, that is intermixing of the orbitals, so we get the beryllium structure over here, the beryllium structure, and that has been combined with the two chlorine atoms over here. Now when coming to the hybridization, what type of hybridization does it involve? So as we have different types of hybridization, like sp2 hybridization, sp3 hybridization, sp3d hybridization, so different hybridizations we have. So this hybridization Which hybridization does it belong as? If you see here, the intermixing of orbitals is done with one s orbital and one p orbital. So this hybridization belongs to sp hybridization. So we call it as sp hybridization. So the barium chloride. So the barium chloride, the angle which is having 180 degrees, and the structure which we call it as a linear structure, and it undergoes the hybridization called the sp hybridization. So I think you got an idea about how does it, the electron which is present in the ground state, gets jump into the excited state. So this happens only when the another atom gets come closer to the beryllium atom, like what we call the nucleus which is present in this chlorine atom gets attract the electron which is present in the beryllium. So this is the beryllium chloride atom structure, the complete structure which we call. And next we have different examples like boron trifluoride. So let's go on to the one each and every example. So here, so as barium chloride has been completed, BeCl2. So barium chloride is being completed by having a structure. So this is the beryllium, and it is been combined with the two chlorine atoms, that is the dumbbell shape of the chlorine atoms, and it has 180 degrees. Its shape is called as a linear shape, and it undergoes sp hybridization, which we call it as the sp hybridization. Now let us move on to the another structure which we call as the boron trifluoride. So boron trifluoride, which we call the BF3. So the central atom here which we have is the boron, atomic number as 5, and when we write the electronic configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, which we call as the ground state. So this is the ground state. As we know, the electron jumps from the ground state to the excited state as the fluorine atoms, with the nucleus which is present in the fluorine is been attracting the electron which is present in the boron. So the electron which is present at the ground state will be move on to the excited state, that is it moves on to 1s2, 2s1. As it goes to the 2p2, that is it moves into 2px1, 2py1, 2pz0. As the pz orbital is not present over here, so we are going to remove it. So the electron which is present in the s orbital moves on to the p orbital. As I've told you before, that we have px, py and pz. As we have px, py, pz, so that one electron already it is present in px, and another electron which is coming from s orbital moves into the py orbital. Now this is called as the excited state. Yes, excited state. Now if you see the structure which is present over here, the s we have the spherical shape, and px which we have the dumbbell shape on the x-axis, and py which have the another dumbbell shape which is present on the y-axis. Now when these three atoms get combined together, so their structure going to be formed as like, so this there are three going to be get combined like this. So this is how the boron gets combined. So this is how the boron atom which is present in the excited state. Now the intermixing of atomic orbitals, that is s orbital, px, py, they combine together and form in the equal size, equal shape and equal energy. So wherever you take the energy at any of the point, the energy will be same. But before, as 2s and 2p, almost the energies are equal, but not exact equal. Now when they get hybridization, now you can take at any point the energies will be equal. Now if you take for the fluorine atom, fluorine we have atomic number 9, as the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. That means we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means the last pz orbital has been unpaired over here. Now that is the dumbbell shape. Now that gets combined over here. One fluorine atom, here one fluorine atom, and here one fluorine atom. So here we have a fluorine atom which is bond over here, and here also which is bond, and here also which is bond. So this, now the boron has a hybridization which comes, as I told you before, here we have one s orbital and two p orbitals. So now can you tell me the hybridization as 1s and 2p orbitals? What can you tell me the hybridization of boron? Yes, that is sp2 hybrid. So that is sp2 hybridization. So this sp2 hybridization, so here also we have a bond which we call as sigma sp2 bond that has been combined with the pz, so we call it as pz bond. So here also we have a sigma bond which is sigma sp2 bond pz, and here also we have a bond which is the sigma sp2 bond pz, and here we have a bond angle which is 120 degrees, and the shape which we have is called the trigonal planar. So this is about the boron trifluoride. So boron trifluoride, the structure which is, we call it a trigonal planar, and the having a bond angle of 120 degrees, which has a hybridization of sp2 hybridization, and here we have a sigma bonds between sigma sp2 with the pz orbital of one fluorine atom, and another three bonds which are combined over here. So this is about the boron trifluoride, its excited state, ground state, and sp2 hybridization. Now when we see, so what we have seen, to S1, as it becomes 3, those 3 will be formed in 2PX1, 2PY1, and 2PZ1. So as here we have one S orbital, PX orbital, PY orbital, and PZ orbital. So according to hybridization, so these 3 atomic orbitals get intermixed together. So they intermix together to form a structure. So this is how the orbital, the carbon gets combined with the one So this is the complete structure of carbon when it moves into the excited state. Now if we see here, one s orbital and three p orbitals are being combined over here, so we call this as sp3 hybridization. So we call it as sp3 hybridization. And the hydrogen, which have only one electron, which is the spherical, that gets combined with the four atomic orbitals of the carbon, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So here we have a bond which is called sigma sp3 bond. As it is combined with s orbitals, we write it as s. Here also sigma sp3 bond s. Sigma sp3 bond s. Here also sigma sp3 bond s, hydrogen atoms. So here we have a bond angle which is 109 degrees 28 minutes. Shape is called as tetrahedron. So this is the shape of the methane molecule, the tetrahedron, which is having a bond angle of 109 degrees and 28 minutes with the hybrid as sp3 hybrid. So this is about the structure formation of the methane molecule. And when we, as methane, let's see again the structure. So here we have sigma sp3 bond s, sigma sp3 bond s. So it's very interesting when you draw, when you practice these structures, as it's make you interesting when you draw it. So 109 degrees 28 minutes with a shape called as tetrahedron, and we have a hybrid which we call it as sp3 hybridization. Now coming to the another, which is ammonium, and here I'm going to draw the direct structure. So this will be the central atom of nitrogen, where we have two lone one lone pair, and it has been combined with the hydrogen atoms. So here we have sigma sp3 bond s, sigma sp3 bond s, and sigma sp3 bond s, which have a bond angle of 104 degrees, is 107 degrees 34 minutes, and we have a shape which we call the trigonal pyramid. Trigonal pyramid. And here also we have hybridization called sp3 hybridization. And the same for water molecule also, the same water molecule. So here we have two lone pairs of oxygen combined with the two hydrogen atoms. And here we have a bond as sp3 bond s, sigma sp3 bond s, which have a bond angle of 104 degrees 5 minutes, and the shape which we call it as V shape or the bend shape. And here also we have a hybridization of sp3 hybridization. So this also same as before, like if we see for ammonia. NH3. So when we draw the nitrogen as 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So that is here s, we have two electrons, and here we have 1, 2, 3. Here which we call as a lone pair, and these are the unpaired electrons which belongs to px, py, and pz. Now the lone pair which we have this orbital over here gets combined with this to form a structure like and here we have a lone pair of nitrogen and here three hydrogen atoms get combined over here as we have hydrogen as 1s1 the spherical shape. So here we have a bond, here also we have a bond and here also. So we have one lone pair and three bond pairs with an angle of 107 degrees 34 minutes, which is shape of trigonal pyramid. Trigonal pyramid, and also here we have a hybridization of sp3 hybridization. So let's see the last one, which is the water molecule. H2O. So central atom has oxygen, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So in next orbital, two electrons are being filled out, and 1, 2, 3, 4. So px is being filled out, and py, pz, we have a single over here. Now here we have two lone pairs which belongs to s orbital and px degenerating orbital. Now when these three get combined together, so here we have two lone pairs of oxygen atom and it's get combined with the hydrogen atom, that is sigma sp3 bond s, sigma sp3 bond s, which is hydrogen, 1s1 spherical shape. Bond angle of 104 degrees 5 minutes. So this minutes gets varies and we have a V shape, or we call as the bend shape also. You can call it as bend shape. So this is about the hybridization and some of the examples of the molecules over here. So today we have discussed about the valency bond theory. So we have discussed about the valency bond theory explained by Linus Pauling. And we have seen about the formation of N2 and O2 molecules over here. And next we have seen about the hybridization. How does the molecules get the exact structure that we have seen here. So barium chloride, boron trifluoride and methane. The ammonium NH3, ammonium NH3 and water molecules H2O. So right now, thank you for your time over here. And we have a special video about the formation of BeCl2. This is a graphical animated video that will be very interesting for you. And right now, thank you for your time. Any doubts regarding the chapter, please give your valuable comments. Your doubts will be clarified, and thank you for your time spending with me. Thank you everyone. So let's see the barium chloride. So one electron, the ground state electron which is more jump onto the p orbital, so the structured s orbital and the p double shape combines together to form an sp hybridization, and the beryllium, which is the sp hybridization, gets combined with the chlorine, that is the p orbital, as we have discussed earlier. And they do combine together to form like this as the P bond PZ orbital, which are having an angle of 180 degrees, and the shape which we get here we call it as the linear shape. So it consists a straight line, the beryllium chloride. So the sp hybridization always have an angle of 180 degrees, and here when we see the hybridization of methane, the ground state electron jumps on to the pz orbital, so it moves on, jump to the pz orbital. Now here we have 1s and 3 suborbitals, that is px, py and pz, so it jumps to the pz orbital,
and the structures are get combined over here, gets to form as sp3 hybridization. So the s orbital, the spherical, px, py, pz on different axes combined together to form the main part of the central atom of the carbon. So which we have the sp3 hybridization, and this sp3 hybridization gets combined with the hydrogen atom, that is the s orbital over here, which we get the sigma sp3 bond s, which is the sigma bond and the strong bond over here, which has an angle of 109 degrees 28 minutes and has a tetrahedron shape. So all the sp3 hybridization has this tetrahedron and has an angle of 109 degrees 28 minutes. Right now, thank you for watching this video.